Well, it was a high-profile murder case in 2008 that stunned the entire community. The half-sister of a local state representative found dead, her body dumped on the street of a West Side neighborhood.
And for the first time in 11 years, we're hearing the details that helped solve the case. And in a surprising twist, how detectives learned this wasn't the suspect's first victim. Our Bill Churchwell now with this true crime report, Catching a Killer.
You don't want to commit homicide in Corpus because you're going to get a good chance getting caught.
December 28th, 2008.
There was a cold night arriving on the scene, and the first thing you see when you pull up with the headlights was a body pretty much naked on the street. This is the one when you show up on the scene, it's your baby, and you got to figure it out.
A young woman beaten and strangled to death, found by a passerby here on Bluebonnet Drive. It was the beginning of a murder investigation.
Take your fingers and frame the scene, and you look at it, and then he tells me the thing that really stops your heart. He goes, okay, LT, you see that? Yeah, I do. That's all we got.
It's a call retired police lieutenant Isaac Valencia will never forget, his first as a homicide supervisor with CCPD. More than a decade later, details on the case flooding back.
In the process of being out there with our new technology and the cars, we saw what appeared to be the shape of a peanut.
That mark, a tattoo. A list of names narrowed down with the use of a mobile database.
That's the nickname on the street, Peanuts. And that's the name of the person.
The victim was 29-year-old Devin Herrero.
And then you realize, oh my God, we know the person.
They had a name and then a witness.
The neighbor said when contacted that they heard the loud muffler of a truck.
A detail that would end up being useful later in the investigation. Meanwhile, the team continued to reach out to those who knew Herrero. The next day, Valencia teaming up to check bus stops along Leopard Street, speaking with those who knew Peanut, all outraged when they found out.
One of the females said that she had just been with her that night, literally within an hour of the last time she was seen alive.
What she said next would crack the case wide open.
And she goes, you want the number? Excuse me?
We pulled police and court documents from the crime. The investigation report goes on to say the woman told police that Devin Herrero had called that number at 2:25 a.m., the day she died, and that a guy with lots of tattoos had picked her up in a truck. It was a number that would eventually lead detectives to this man, Esteban Ruiz, a man who turns out owned a truck with a loud muffler and lived just one block away on the same street where Herrero's lifeless body was found. A check of Ruiz's home reveals more.
They saw some burned stuff on the ground, and remnants were still visible of what her last clothing looked like.
It furthered the case.
And all this within a 36-hour period from the start to actually nailing who we knew it was.
Ruiz turning himself into police after a warrant for his arrest was issued. The charge, murder. He received 40 years in prison for the crime as part of a plea deal. But as Ruiz began to serve his time behind bars, a shocking new discovery.
What stood out about this is I believe he's a serial killer.
Quite amazing, the police work that went into solving this case. Again, just 36 hours to figure out a suspect.
Wow, Bill.
Excellent.
Incredible job with this report. Now, did authorities believe that this man was tied to other murders?
Well, this was a case that eventually exposed a previous unsolved murder. Coming up tomorrow night, how police were able to pin Ruiz to the crime. And was there a third victim? It's something that would have made Ruiz a serial killer. That story coming up tomorrow on 3 News at 10 o'clock.
Can't wait for that. All right, Bill, thank you.
Thank you, Bill.